Yeah.
Hey, come on, lay it on me.
No.
How did he come back? Why is he back? Oh, there's a freaking skeleton necromancer around here, and he just brought back the skeleton mage.
Unrelenting. Okay, balance.
Gosh, dang it. Okay, where's that freaking necromancer? He's just like right here somewhere. Where is he? Oh, okay, so that skeleton just like came back to life on his own accord. GG.
There goes one. Give me another one. Give me another one. God damn it.
Yeah, usually before I fight Alduin, I usually get to about level 25, 30, somewhere around there.
Same here. I defeated Alduin when I was level 17. I was level 17, but my archery skill was all the way, and all I did was use sneak. So I used shout, sneak, and yeah, it was pretty awesome.
Right, so I just reached level 6, finally.
I'm still level 5. Lydia? Oh yeah, another one of my textures I did was made girls' faces look a whole lot more prettier.
Yeah, that's the same like body mod that I have.
Yeah.
Mine's called CBBE.
What's...
The problem is if you make the mistake like I did, then some of your girls may end up nude.
Well, it's okay, though. I mean, it's a simple mistake. It's just better than guys being nude, huh?
Well, that's actually a mod that I have also called Better Males.
Oh, God,
and all that, because the males are freaking ugly as crap in this game.
Damn, dude.
But thankfully, I have the underwear edition, so they all have underwear on.
Okay, that's good. No thong, just underwear.
Just underwear.
Oh, here we go. I'm gonna learn Whirlwind Spirit.
You will now see how you learn a complete. Didn't I have like a... Oh, there it is.
Alright,
I'm gonna upgrade my crossbow to superior. I'm gonna also upgrade this steel armor that I have and see if I can actually get any more steel armor.
Okay, give me
and upgrade this quest.
I'm not getting a new shout.
All right, let's see. Steel ingots. I need two of those.
Did he give it to me already? You asshole. Give me a shout. Don't tell me. Did my game... Oh, no.
Did your game freeze? God, I hate it when it freezes.
It's not frozen this time.
Good.
Kind of happy about that. So
now I have 106 steel bolts. Yeah.
Stare into the word of wood.
So before I go and fight that dragon, I'm actually going to go and fight down a couple of bandit camps. That way I can maybe get full steel armor. Maybe.
Okay, quit.
So I have to go to Red Drones Retreat and Silent Boots Camp. Alright, I'm going to buy a horse. Because...
I'm waiting for...
You know, I do have a mod that allows me to summon a He-Man's cat. What's the cat's name?
He-Man!
But what's the cat's name? I can't remember what the cat's name is.
I don't know. No one really liked the cat that much. It was mostly the He-Man that everybody loved.
He-Man, I have the power!
Wait, have you heard the He-Man song?
Yeah.
Another YouTube star right there. What's going on?
And I say, hey, yeah, yeah. Oh my gosh. Alright, so now I am riding through the fields, wielding my giant ultra great sword.
Well, I'm about to go blue. Why haven't you opened up the gate yet, dog? Lydia, get the hell out of my way!
Oh, that's right, the Silent Moon's Camp. This has a forge in it, I believe. Or something.
God,
like a forge.
Damn, dude, Lydia can piss me off.
Your quick mastery of a new thune.
Oh, yeah, you know what? I do have a mod that allows me to quick unmount off of a horse. Like, I can just
drop.
Literally just drop off of a horse, but totally like forgotten how to do it.
All right, so I'm gonna go purchase some steel, iron, and some leather, and I'm gonna build some Lord of the Rings weapons.
No, don't see me, 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 don't see me.
You got saw.
No, these bandits are like chasing animals and all that for no apparent reason. And all that, and I just don't want them to see me because I want to get sneak attacks. I want to raise my sneak skill.
You know, since I'm a wood elf, should I do like a Legolas thing? Should I do double elven blades?
I don't know. Like, if you have the like bow, I think go for it.
Oh yeah, they have the bow too. And I can either, the thing that sucks though, they don't have Gimli's axe. That would have been the best Lord of the Rings attachment ever. Alright, I guess. Oh. No way. You
there. You're the one that. How come I cannot hit this guy? Frick. When Lord Mirak appears, all shall bear witness. There we go, frick. Like I'm like 100 meters or like 100 yards away from this dude and I was having so much trouble hitting him. He's like, come on, I'm not that bad. I keep forgetting that the left click with the crossbow is a bash.
I died! No! Cultist just showed out of nowhere.
Lol.
Why? I'm only level 5 and they just showed up. That's annoying.
I like how I'm one-shotting all these bandits with freaking my crossbow. Like,
yeah.
I'm not even sneaking. At this point, I'm literally just one-shotting them.
I'm gonna, like, turn away from the mission for a while and start getting some money and enhance my armor and everything. Because right now, I just died by these stupid cultists.
Like, to, like, some of the easiest enemies in the game?
Yes. Even though I will take their armor, though, because if I remember right, cultist armor is pretty good. Like, good beginning. Waiting.
Ooh. Oh, dang it. Those are good.
Oh,
gosh. Dang it. I can't believe that. Oh, you would come across you those.
You're the one they called.
I found hide bracers of major wielding, and it makes your one-handed attacks 25% stronger. That's really good. But freaking, of course, I'm a two-handed.
So I can already do the mission, I could already go to Solstein.
Wouldn't be a good idea.
Yeah, I mean, but if I did it right now, that'd be kind of cool.
Yeah, like, that's
Lydia died! Yay! Oh my god, I could steal her armor.
Her steel armor? Yeah, that's actually that's actually a pretty good reason to just let her die, actually.
Oh, thank God Lydia died. I mean, I sound messed up, but it's true. Steel Nordic gauntlets and a steel sword. Oh, thank you, Lydia.
Alright, so that bandit leader's taken care of.
I'll always remember you as someone who
who followed gave me armor.
Yeah, and who followed me everywhere. Or you know what I could do? I could make some I could do some Sauron maces too, if I could think about it.
Like dual Sauron maces?
Yeah. You know what? That I might do that. Screw it.
I keep finding lunar weapons.
Lunar?
Yeah. Completely and totally useless, but...
Alright, just waiting, waiting, waiting. Oh boy. It is pretty damn dark in my room.
Like, I always have a lamp on. So yeah, I keep it on like 24/7, I swear.
I should have put that on. Alright, let's check on what I can make with my steel.
You know, that was like one of the decisions from like my YouTube channel was like, should I do like total face cam or not? But you know what? Face cam honestly kind of ruins certain Let's Plays. Well, like,
I hate when people have like the face that you really don't want to look at. You look at them and you're like, I don't really want to look at your face right now. You're just looking. Should I go for
look at your face right now.
I don't want to look at your face. I could do Blades Armor if I wanted to right now.
Nice. Like, I like face cams, but only in certain situations. Like,
yeah.
Like, only in, like, horror games and other games that it makes sense for you to have a face cam. Like, say if somebody's doing an Oculus Rift video, yeah, a face cam is great. Got some good people. But
yeah, horror games
if,
are the best.
If you're just, you know, playing Skyrim, no.
I mean,
like,
if you
there's
think
no
it, though,
reason.
I think
there's no reason to have a face cam.
The new Slender game coming out would be a good, you know.
You know, I've never played any of the Slender Man games.
You haven't? Oh, you're
no.
missing out.
Like I saw so many videos about it. I'm just like, you know what? Like, I get scared pretty easily. Like, horror games definitely would terrify me quite a bit, but it just didn't really look that scary to me. Like, I have Amnesia, The Dark Descent, and A Machine for Pigs, and I've played them both, and they both scared me quite good. But freaking like, there's so many other games like Cry of Fear and I'm Afraid of Monsters that are just such good games and all that, such good horror games. And then I just see these really cheaply made, you know, like Slender games and all that. Like, some
yeah.
of them are well made, but most of them are very cheap flashlight games, and I'm just like, you know what? This doesn't deserve the praise it's getting. Like, even if a whole bunch of people like it, like, it really doesn't deserve what it's getting. There's so many other games. Like, Slender is getting 10 times the amount of attention that, like, Amnesia got. And, like, Cry of Fear got. Games that deserved the hype.
That is true. But I have to admit, though, Slender is... It's pretty good. It's a pretty good game, not to lie, and it's cheaper than Amnesia.
Well, I think it's free, isn't it? Like,
if I remember right, yeah.
Yeah, so that's like its one thing. Like, I can forgive it because it's free, but if it would have cost like any money, I'd have been like, yeah, this is bullcrap. All
right.
Yeah, because that game's honestly, like, unless they were to, like, really make some headway on it, it's not really worth any money.
You know what I should do? Nah, I shouldn't. Should I?
Whoa, the Bandit Chief is just like a chicken address. What the heck?
I'm thinking about going to Solstheim and then, like, hella quick, get all the... Get the Stalrim armor, Deathbrand. You know how cheap that would be if I had all the Deathbrand armor, like, before level 10? I think that would be pretty badass. I mean, I'd be unstoppable.
I don't know, but I just found some steel Imperial gauntlets.
We did?
You tried mercenary?
Yep,
war?
Off of a Bandit Chief. She also had, like, this Nord chainmail thing, which is part of a custom mod, obviously. But I've tried to wear it before, and I don't like the way it looks, so...
I'd even buy one of trinkets, odds and ends.
Padded fur hood. Yeah, like, there's a whole bunch of, like, there's, like, a whole bunch of, like, armor, light armor stuff in this, mods that I have. Like, it's cool and all, but since I'm being a heavy armor character, it really sucks that I can't I can't find any good heavy armor.
That's okay.
Okay, so apparently I picked up Amarin's family sword. Oh, I did.
Already?
That yeah.
Quick.
Okay, now where's the flippin' exit? Is this the exit? No, this is not the exit. This way is the exit. Yeah, so we're here.
Alright, so, I need to get some steel.
I'm going to go and fight the dragon now.
Alright.
Do come back.
Good luck, good luck.
I'm going to head back to the Whiterun stables and get my horse, and actually, I'll get my horse. My horse is tough.
Kind of. Depends.
If you need horses,
yeah. Right. I think that was the one thing that the mod maker for that He-Man's cat, like, warned, is that the cat is, like, stupendously overleveled, like, compared to every other mount. So,
like Shadowmere?
Yeah, it will wreck just about anything. So I doubt I'll actually ever use it just because of that.
Alright.
But I can like call him at any time. I think there's a chest over in Whiterun Stables.
The big W.
The big W that allows me to summon him.
The W. We speak its name.
It's like a horn or something.